Today, I want to briefly introduce you to an app called TiddlyWiki. Its main purpose is to be your own personal wiki, but it is also suitable for general note-taking and Zettelkasten. I'll briefly show you how it works, then I'll talk about some positive and negative aspects of it, comparing it with similar apps like Obsidian. Down in the description below, I put a link to the official desktop app. After opening it and clicking on Create New Wiki, it should look something like this. Here, we give our wiki a name, a description, and we choose what the main page is going to be. I'll set the main page to be an article called Index, which doesn't exist yet, but we will create it soon. We click on Save right here, and that's it. Our wiki is set up. So let me show you how to use it. Now, just like a Zettelkasten is made of Zettels, a TiddlyWiki is made of Tiddlers. You can think of Tiddlers, which are these rectangles here, as single notes, single Zettels, or single wiki articles. We create new Tiddlers with the plus button here. We can give them a title, tags, and content. We can also create links to other Tiddlers through the use of square brackets, just like you would expect from a wiki. We click on the tick, and the Tiddler is saved. Clicking on the pen puts it into edit mode again. I wanted to show one extra feature that I think is pretty neat, that is the ability to wholesale reproduce a Tiddler's content in another Tiddler. I'll show you what I mean. I'll create one called, say, Pareto Principle, which I want to include in my index page. All I need to do is to enclose within curly brackets the Tiddler name, Pareto Principle, then save, and we can see that it reproduced the entire content of the Pareto Principle Tiddler here. If we then go and edit the original, like so, the text will be updated everywhere. Quite handy. Tiddlers stay open until you close them with the X, and you can run a full search of all of your notes from this box right here. These are the basics, but for some more features, we can look at the treasure trove that is the tools button. I won't go through it all, but we can, for instance, create a new journal entry, pre-populated with the date format and tag of our choice. Or, when things get too hectic and we want a panic button to close all of the open Tiddlers, well, here is that button. And in fact, we can create a quick shortcut to it, like so. You can already see just from this brief introduction how TiddlyWiki meets and far exceeds any expectations one might have from this genre of interconnected note-taking software. So is TiddlyWiki suitable and sufficient for Zettelkasten? Absolutely, albeit with some small caveats I'll talk about later on in the video. So how does it compare with other apps of its kind, such as Obsidian, for instance, and what are some of its pros and cons? Let's start from the pros. When it comes to a second brain type app, we want it to be as stable, mature, and supported as possible, since we're going to use it on a daily basis. TiddlyWiki has been around the block a few times. It will indeed turn 16 at the end of 2020, all while being maintained by the same developer, Jeremy Rustin, who updates it very frequently. Plus, it's open source, which is great. Our entire wiki here will be one single HTML file. That makes it extremely portable, easy to synchronize, and easy to back up. Indeed, all you need to do to synchronize it with other devices is to place it into a service like Dropbox or Google Drive. I have to say though that when viewing the wiki from a web browser, you are not going to be able to edit it, so that is a limiting factor. But there are apps that allow you to circumvent this, like Quine2 for iOS. So yes, you will be able to edit your wiki on the go on your iPhone or iPad. Normally, all of your Tiddlers are visible as plain text when opening the wiki file with a text editor. So if we were going to synchronize our wiki with, say, Dropbox, we would essentially be uploading our entire second brain in plain text to the internet. TiddlyWiki has support for full encryption. Go to Tools, click on Set Password, type it in, and you're set. The encryption is not just superficial here. Every single Tiddler gets encrypted within the HTML file, providing us with some peace of mind when uploading our wiki to online services. If you want to extend the functionality of TiddlyWiki, well, there are plugins for that. The official repository now lists about 60, but anyone can distribute them outside of quote-unquote official channels. For instance, there are plugins that allow you to create mind maps, use Markdown in your Tiddlers, and more. Moving to things that might be considered as negatives, If you are looking for a Zettelkasten-centric app, Obsidian is probably a better choice. TiddlyWiki was not conceived with Zettelkasten in mind. It is a personal wiki app, and as such, it doesn't show you backlinks or an automatically updated graph of your notes. More detail on those in my Obsidian video. Ultimately though, one might say that given the extensibility of TiddlyWiki, creating plugins to do that would be possible. If your goal is not a Zettelkasten though, but a personal wiki, then this might be the one for you. Lastly, the biggest negative for me is also one of TiddlyWiki's strengths. That is, it's only one file. While yes, that makes it extremely portable, synchronizable, and all that, if you create your notes in TiddlyWiki, you can only interface with them on TiddlyWiki. Yes, you can export them in bulk, but once you exported them, you've only created a copy of them. Other apps like Obsidian create one file per note and leave them as is on the file system. This means that potentially we can use the same folder of notes with multiple different apps, allowing us the freedom to choose the best tool for the job at hand. For instance, you might use Obsidian for the graph view, but IA Writer for its performance, and so on. I am not aware of any TiddlyWiki plugin that allows one to have multiple file support, but if there is one, please do write a comment below. To wrap it up, I recommend you give TiddlyWiki a try. It's completely free and open source, so there's no harm in playing around with it. It's a software made not for Zettelkasten, but for personal wikis, so if that's something you're looking for, this might just be it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next one.